इज इंडिया ग्लेजा, इट इज़ अ सॉलिड स्टेट लेजा, इट इज़ अ फोर लेवल लेजर सिस्टम, सो इट कैन बी ऑपरेटेड इन कंटिन्यूस वेव मोड. हियर एन डी स्टैंड्स फॉर नियोडाइमियम आयन्स एंड याक स्टैंड्स फॉर इट्रियम एल्यूमिनियम गार्नेट. दिस इट्रियम एल्यूमिनियम गार्नेट इज एन ऑप्टिकली आइसोट्रोपिक क्रिस्टल. इन दिस क्रिस्टल सम ऑफ द इट्रियम आयन्स आर रिप्लेस्ड बाई नियोडाइमियम आयन्स. दिस इट्रियम एल्यूमिनियम गार्नेट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द लेजिंग एक्शन. इट जस्ट सर्व्स एज अ होस्ट लैटाइस इन विच सम ऑफ द नियोडाइमियम आयन्स कैन बी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. दिस डायग्राम शोज द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एंडियाग लेजर. हियर यू कैन सी वन इलिप्टिकल रिफ्लेक्टर, एंडियाग रॉड, सॉलिड स्टेट लेजर. सो एंडियाग रॉड अलॉन्ग विथ अ क्रिप्टॉन लैम्प इज केप्ट इन साइड दिस इलिप्टिकल रिफ्लेक्टर. This Endiag rod is kept at one of the focus and Krypton arc lamp is kept at the other focus. Now here the type of pumping that we are using is optical pumping. So the light emitted by this Krypton arc lamp will be utilized for exciting the neodymium ions from lower energy level to higher energy levels. So the method of pumping is optical pumping. And why are we using elliptical reflector? We are using elliptical reflector in order to make best use of light energy for exciting the neodymium ions. Because we are keeping the Endiag rod at one of the focus and Krypton lamp is kept at the other focus, all the light rays emitted by the Krypton arc lamp after getting reflected from the wall will arrive at the other focus where the Krypton rod is kept. So the light energy is not wasted and entire light energy is utilized for exciting the neodymium ions to the higher levels. So this is the purpose of using elliptical reflector. Here a resonant cavity is formed with the help of two mirrors, one of which is fully reflecting mirror and the other one is partially reflecting mirror. The laser beam can be obtained from the partially reflecting mirror. So laser beams come out in this direction in this case. This capacitor is power supply, trigger pulse, these are the things necessary for running this Krypton lamp. So this is a simple construction of Endiag laser. In Endiag laser, neodymium ions are the active centers. Why neodymium ions are active centers? Because they are characterized with some metastable state where the neodymium ions can rest for long time and therefore population inversion can be achieved. Yttrium aluminium garnet is a crystal in which some of the yttrium ions are replaced by neodymium ions. Here this yttrium aluminium garnet has nothing to do with the lasing action. It just serves as a host lattice in which the active centers, namely neodymium ions, can be placed. Let us try to understand working of Endiag laser using energy level diagram of neodymium ions. It is a four level laser system. So the population inversion is achieved between E3 and E2. So ground level is not involved here. So lasing action will occur between the two energy levels, E2 and E3. As a first step, the light energy coming from Krypton lamp is utilized in exciting the neodymium ions to the higher energy levels. So this is the fourth level actually. E4, E5, E6. In a four level laser system, this group of energy levels will serve the purpose of fourth level. All these energy levels are normal states, normal levels. None of them is a metastable state. So the neodymium ions coming here will not rest here for long time. Immediately they will fall once their lifetime in these levels get over, which is of the order of 10 raised to minus 8 seconds. They will immediately fall to the lower energy levels. So some of them will come to E3, some of them will directly come to E2, or some of them will directly come to E1 also. The neodymium ions coming to E2 will immediately fall to E1. But here the neodymium ions which are falling to E3 due to spontaneous emission will rest here for long time because this level is a metastable state. And as the neodymium ions are residing here for longer time, the number of neodymium ions in energy E3 will become greater than number of neodymium ions in energy level E2. So the population inversion can be achieved between E3 and E2. And once the population inversion is achieved, we can initiate the lasing action, or the one of the photon coming from krypton lamp having the energy E3 minus E2 can be utilized for initiating the lasing action, and we will get a laser beam of wavelength 1.06 micrometers or 10,600 angstroms. So the laser beam given by ENDIAG laser has got the wavelength 10,600 angstroms, which doesn't lie in the visible region. It will be in infrared region. Because it is a four-level laser system, the population inversion can be easily maintained, and therefore it can be operated in continuous wave mode. Efficiency of better than 1% can be achieved with the help of ENDIAG laser. These ENDIAG lasers can be used in industrial applications like resistor trimming, welding, hole drilling, or some medical applications also for doing the surgery. So this is about ENDIAG laser. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.